Hey everyone, welcome to Berlin Builds. Today I'm going to show you how to do a rounded corner with your baseboard.
Here it is, the very tricky rounded corner. Remember the first time I did rounded corners, it was an adventure, and I want to help you not have to have quite the adventure that I had in my life. So there's a few things that you're going to need to make it so that your rounded corners don't end up looking like this. Yeah, I found that on a job. A guy hired me to come do the stair skirts for him. And he was all in a rush. He had just finished this basement for a rental. And I was like, why did he not have his other finished carpenter do the stair skirts? And I found that, and I think I answered my own question. So anyways, a few different things are gonna make your life easier. One is this little jig by Bench Dog. I'll put a link in the description below for these different things that I'm gonna show you. This is for a 3/4 inch radius quarter round. Now, this one is not 3/4 inch. You rarely run into these. Almost all the quarter rounds I've ever run into are the 3/4 inch. However, this is a 1/2 inch. So we're in luck, because if you don't feel like going on the Amazon and buying one of these, I'll show you how you can make your own that looks like this. Ooh, looks just like a corner. Weird, right? So you're gonna need a jig of some kind. Whether you make it or you buy it, I recommend buying it, but it's okay if you wanna make it. You're gonna need a 5-in-1 tool. What this is for cleaning up the corners to make sure that there's no crud on them, so that way it doesn't mess up your miters. So this is a 5-in-1 tool. You can see mine's been loved. I actually found it out in the dirt on a job site once, and it's become mine, and I have loved it since then. This is a protractor. You're gonna want one of these. This is gonna make your life a lot easier. This is gonna make it so that you know exactly what angle you need to be cutting your miters at. So a protractor. And then you're also gonna need super glue. And not just super glue, you're gonna want an accelerant to make your super glue dry faster, because America. So you're gonna need those, and then you're probably gonna need some sort of snack, like Tootsie Rolls, or these Albanese gummy bears. These things are amazing, because you might get angry. Especially if this is your first time, you're probably gonna wanna have something handy that's gonna make you feel good, like a snack, or a Dr. Pepper, or some really chill music, I don't know, Jack Johnson, something great like that. So just kind of relax. You need to go a little slow on your first few, and it's gonna be all right. So let me take you through the next step. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a scrap piece of base, because we're making our jig first, because without the jig, your life will be miserable. So one thing to remember as you're doing this is to keep your stock tight to the fence. Now, a lot of people are gonna think, oh, I can just cut this with the baseboard standing up. And that's something that you can do. But keep in mind, most baseboard comes in 16-foot lengths. So what will happen is, if you're cutting it in a standing position, there's a high likelihood that you're not gonna have this piece dead flat on this base of your saw. And if you do that, all of a sudden this line won't be straight up and down, it's gonna go off to the side. So not only do you wanna keep your material tight to the fence, it's usually gonna be easier if you cut it laying flat. You're gonna get a better result most of the time. So I'm gonna recommend cutting it flat. Another thing to think about is, if I'm gonna use this side against my fence, I'm gonna keep that side against the fence the entire time. And you might say, oh, it's gonna be a lot easier and faster if you just cut it once and then flip it and cut it again. And you're not wrong, but that would drop in stuff. So if you do that, what you're gonna find out is that these lines are probably not perfectly parallel with each other. And if you're trying to make your jig, it's paramount that this thing is dead on accurate. So for the sake of making your jig, reference off of the same side of the baseboard with each cut. Now, you're probably wondering, this is all great, Nick, but what degree of an angle do I need to cut it for my jig? You're gonna wanna set it at 23 degrees for your angle cuts. And this is why. No corner is a perfect 90 degrees. So you're gonna be a little over 90 degrees, which means that your angle is gonna be a little bit open. And that's because mudders are a little bit free with their mud on corners. So the likelihood of you finding a 90 degree corner is pretty slim. So if you go a little bit wider, it's gonna be right most of the time. Now, that's why you have the protractor, is so that you can know exactly what you need to do for each corner. More on that later. But for the sake of making your jig, if you go at 23 degrees, you're probably gonna be a happy camper. Now my saw is set at a 23 degree angle. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start cutting the little middle piece first. So see how it's coming down at this angle? Come to the right side and cut that off. Now, just to make sure that we're being super accurate with our lives, what we're gonna do is we're gonna double check and make sure it's 5/16 at the top, and we'll go down to the bottom and make sure it's 5/16 down there as well. If it's less on one side or more on the other side, that means that you probably weren't holding the piece tight enough to the fence, or you flipped it around, or your saw isn't accurate. All three are not good things, but hopefully you get it so it's the same. Now, for the sake of not boring you, I'm gonna make two more cuts off camera. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the two sides that go on this. I'm gonna cut the right side and the left side, or right side and left side, however you want. I don't know, I'm backwards because I'm looking this way. So I'm gonna cut the two sides. And what I'm gonna do is that short point of the miter to where I do that 90 degree angle is gonna be 1 inch exactly, because that will make your life a lot easier. If you wanna go 15/16, that's on you, but I don't like adding 15/16 to everything. I'd rather add an inch. So do it at an inch. It's gonna make your life a lot easier. I'll cut those two pieces and I'll show you the next step. Okay, we've got our three pieces cut. So you can see we have the left side, we have the middle, and we have the right side, okay? Unless you're looking at it from my direction, this would be left, middle, and right, but whatever. So we've got these three pieces cut. So from this point right there to here is exactly 1 inch. You're gonna wanna double check the tops and the bottoms to make sure it's precise, because you're making a jig and jigs have to be precise or else it's worthless. So anyways, now that we have these pieces cut, what I like to do is I'll lay them out how they go together. Now, if you have a flat base, you're gonna have an eased top edge. Make sure that you get those all lined up, because it's embarrassing if you glue the bottom to the top. Not that I've ever done that. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna take some super glue, and we're gonna take one of the pieces, and we're gonna run a bead of super glue down the side. Maybe if it wants to come out. There we go. So give it a good little amount of super glue there. You don't need to destroy it and make it go crazy, but you need super glue. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna start rubbing this. You might be like, Nick, you have Accelerant. Why are you not spraying it? I'm not spraying it because it's the jig. I just wanna make sure I have plenty of time to line this up absolutely 100% perfect. Being a finished carpenter breeds being an OCD person. If you don't want to be OCD, maybe don't do finished carpentry. So anyways, now, I'm gonna let that dry for a little bit. This is when you have your snacks. This is when you eat your gummy bears, which I'm not sponsored by Albanese, but if they wanna sponsor me, I would gladly put that on my truck. I would write Albanese gummy bears on my truck because they are amazing. Not sponsored yet. But anyways, I'm gonna give this some time. Eat your snacks. You can practice your bottle flipping skills. Aha! Go chill and listen to Jack Johnson. Whatever, just let it dry. So, I went and did those things while I was talking about them, YouTube magic. So this is dry now. What we're gonna do is now we're gonna take more super glue and we're gonna do the same thing to the other side. Now, if you don't like getting super glue on your fingers, there's some tricks to not getting it on your fingers. I don't know what those tricks are, so you'll probably have to watch a different YouTube video, because I always get super glue on my fingers when I'm doing this. I think you just kind of have to embrace that part of life. Just embrace that sucky thing, or sticky thing, I should say. Just embrace that and let it be cool, because who likes to be able to feel what you're touching with your fingertips, right? Anyways, let that dry. And once it's dry, you're gonna go take it to a corner and you're gonna see how cool you are. If you get a little bit of extra super glue that's kind of right on the edge, you can take another scrap piece and just run it along and scrape off the extra super glue. If you don't do this, there's a high likelihood that super glue will end up on your fingers, which if you like and you're down for that, then just leave it there, but you can just scrape it off. Okay, now that it's dry, we stick it on that corner. Look how tight that is. Such a happy thing in life, right? You have now just made your very own jig, which means that you should probably go and do a jig or something. I don't know. Now that you made your jig and you're thinking, that's very nice, Nick, but what on earth does that jig do for me? Well, let me show you. What that does now is you can hold that tight to the corner, and now you can mark with little crow's feet exactly where this board needs to end on your wall and where this board needs to end. So now what you can do is you can measure from the wall to this point and know exactly how long you need this board to be. And you can do the same thing from here to here. Now this is kind of cool because this is a rounded corner to a rounded corner. I'm going to show you how to do that as well. All right, everyone. Remember how I was so particular about making sure these little side pieces were an inch? Well, I was looking at the footage that I filmed and I didn't tell you why. So anyways, you make these an inch because what you can do is you can actually just put your little jig on the corner and then you can draw a line like this on each side. And then what you can do is you can measure from the other wall to your line that you just did. So in this case, this can be 44 and a quarter plus. And now what I know is that the piece actually needs to be 45 and a quarter plus. You just have to add an inch to it. So that is why you make those little side pieces dead on an inch. Now we have those two points marked. And on the other side of this corner, where we have the rounded corner and then rounded corner, I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm gonna mark where those short points of the miter are. Okay, and now that I have those marked, I'm gonna take a protractor, and I'm gonna stick it on the wall, like this, and I'm gonna see what it says. So, right here, you can see it's calling out just shy, I don't know if my camera will focus, but it's calling out just shy of 46 degrees. Now, since we're cutting that angle into two different miters, you have to cut that in half, so 23 degrees. And when you're right dead close to 23, it's gonna work out just fine. So, 23 degree angles for that one, and then for this one over here, this one is calling out right on at 45. So this one's calling out 22 and a half degrees, and that one's calling out 23 degrees. So I like to take note of that. 22 degrees, 22 and a half degrees, sorry. 22 and a half degrees, and then 23 degrees. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my tape, I'm gonna run it tight to that wall, and I'm gonna measure, and it's showing 23 and a half. So I know that this needs to be 23 and a half inches long from that wall to the short point of this miter. And now I can do the same thing right here. So I can measure from here to here, and I'm showing 4 1/8. Oh, we'll go 4 3/16. 4 3/16. And you can do the same thing with this wall. 23 5/8. So, what that's done for me is I now have my measurement for this wall, this piece, and this piece. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut all those different pieces with these little center ones, and then I'm gonna glue them all together, and then I'm gonna slide the whole piece onto the wall. Now, if you're just doing a corner, it's really easy. You just cut the corner, glue it all together before you put it on the wall, and then just slide it on and nail it on. You don't have to go through as much of a process. I wanted to show you something that's a little bit harder because if you run into something harder, I'd rather show that to you, right? So I have all of those pieces cut. Now, what's a really smart thing to do when you're first learning to do this is to go take your pieces to your corner and put them in place and make sure that it all will fit without even gluing them. That way you don't have to, like if you're like an eighth of an inch off or something, you don't have to recut these because once they're all glued, you can't really reuse it too easy. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna glue them, but I'm gonna use the accelerant to make it go a little bit faster. When I was doing the jig, I just wanted the time to make sure it was super precise. With the accelerant, you have to go kind of fast, but just line it up and then hold it for about 10 seconds and it should hold really well. So now that you have it in place and you've been super gentle, what you're gonna do is you're gonna nail it. Now, the mistake that a lot of people will do, they're gonna come to nail guns and they're gonna nail right here on your tiny, tiny little fragile piece. And that is a poor choice. Don't do that. Just nail around it. So if it's a really small piece, and then like the length, I usually use an 18 gauge. I'm gonna go with my 15 gauge. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna push it right here, and this is a stud right here. So I'm going to nail it right into that stud, like so. And that's going to do is it's going to help protect this little corner. So now we can nail down. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to come around here. What we can do now is we can nail on this front face right here. As well as this one. So what we need to do now is nail on this side. Like so. Then we can come down here. Now you always have to be aware of plumbing. This is in the bathroom. I have a drain coming out right here. So I'm not going to nail directly under the drain. That's a poor life choice. So I might be being too picky, but this opened up ever so slightly while I was doing that, while I was nailing it on. The glue had it quite set with the super glue, and it opened up here just a little bit at the bottom. So what you can do is this is a brand new blade for my razor blade. What I'm doing is I'm gonna carve off because it's overhanging just a little bit. I just carved that off. See how that now following that plane so the miter doesn't extend past the plane of this. So by carving that off, now what I can do is I just can come in with a little bit of spackling right through there, and it will make that a flawless little corner. Just a little bit more. There you go. And you should be able to feel, it should feel completely, totally smooth when you do it. So now I've just got a little bit of spackling on my 5-in-1 tool. Would you believe that? Another use. They say there's only 5 uses for this tool. That is a lie. There's a million uses for this tool. I'm really careful not to smear that on the tile. I'm just gonna push that spackling in with my finger. And then I'm gonna wipe off some of the extra. And you see how we just made that little boo-boo just completely go away? That is how you can just really nitpick your stuff and make it look really tight.
Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can get more videos like this. Comment any questions that you might have below, and make sure you hit that like button because YouTube likes that.